Hi there, YouTube. Welcome back to another episode of my streaming shenanigans. Today, we are checking out a game called Ghost Hunters, which recently released. It came out last week. And I'm basically just explaining the rundown on how to play the game, the basics, what to do, how to investigate the ghost, as well as successfully capturing the ghost as well. Please make sure that you like and subscribe if you enjoyed the content. Head over to my Twitch, drop me a follow if you want to be part of the live streaming action. And if you have any questions or anything you want to know about the game, please drop them in the comments below and let me know what you think. Thank you for watching. I'll see you soon. All right, so this is our normal difficulty, abandoned house. Checking out ghost watches. All right, so this is our van. This is how we usually start off with on the normal difficulty. This is our equipment. If you're not too familiar with most ghost games, you get your standard equipment, which usually just helps you determine certain types of evidence which is needed in the game. Pushing down tab will bring up your tablet, which tells you the different things that you actually need to do in order to identify the kind of ghost that you're dealing with. So you'd need thermometer, EMF, footprints, particle counter, Ouija board, radio, and voodoo doll evidence in order to narrow down the ghost type. So your thermometer, which is over there, your EMF, which is over there, footprints you determine with your UV, particle counter, which is this little device over there, your Ouija board, which is that over there, the radio, which is that over there, and then your voodoo doll. So we're gonna grab a thermometer as well as an EMF and a UV for starters. We also have our protective items, which this is the plasma doohickey, and then this is the withering light. So they both protect you, but they have a cooldown after being used. They can be effective against they are effective against most ghost types, but it will tell you later on in the line on the tablet what works and what doesn't. So you've got your shop over here, which if you've played before, you accumulate money and you can buy more items in the game. You don't have an inventory like in Faz, so it doesn't actually keep what you've bought from your previous game. On the insane difficulty is the only difficulty in which you actually lose your items. So we're gonna go in. I'm just gonna drop some of these items, then we're gonna take our protective items with in case the ghost attacks, and that will keep us from dying. Okay, hello Ghosty. Hi Chris, I love this game. It's awesome. Very, very awesome. So we're picking up our withering light and our... I can't remember the name of this thing exactly. It's called a plasma absorber. There we go. There we go. All right, so I'm going to dump one over here. And then we're going to dump this over here. So basically to pick things up is like your usual E, and then to drop them is right click. So I'm gonna walk around with these three items. We're gonna check to see if we can find any evidence of footprints or anything with the UV while we're going around. Oh, there we go. Okay, so that's right there would be under footprints, would be bloodstains. So this lowers down or narrows down the possibilities of either it being a vampire or darkness. Unfortunately, the game is... Oh. I'm getting dragged. A mechanic in the game which is very unique and can be quite frightening at first. The ghost has the ability to just drag you to a random location on the map. All right, so we have bloodstains, which we have that in our tablets. Awesome. You're watching a video on how Stray prepared our cats for the... Whoa, that's awesome. All right, so let's see if we can get... Whoa! Okay, so the fact that the temps are this high automatically tells me that it is a vampire. It is the only ghost that I know of at the moment that has very, very, very high temps. So already we know this is a vampire because our thermometer is reading very, very high temperatures. So this is very cool. All right, so 50 degrees Celsius is not normal. Okay, so that's our withering light working because the ghost is trying to attack. Since we already know it's a vampire, I'm not going to be using the EMF. We're going to go fetch other equipment from the van. You'll be lucky, no worries. All right, so we're going to grab this and we're going to grab that. And to protect ourselves, I'm just going to choose something random. So over here, this basically tells you what works against the vampire. So this is holy water. These are salts. The plasma absorber, the withering light, a silver bomb, as well as the fire. It's like a tiki torch. So this will basically protect you. As long as you use these things in the map, you'll be fine. And you shouldn't die if you're within proximity of the ghost hunting you. These items are used to protect you as well as to irritate the ghost if you have it as an objective on the board, which we do. Hi Weasley, good morning, how are you? Hello. So these are side objectives which you can do for extra cash as well. As you complete them, you'll actually hear a little jingle go off in the game. I'm gonna grab a flashlight and we're gonna try and see if we can get some particles in the particle counter. Oh, this is a mirror. If you find it throughout the map, you can use this to basically see where the ghost is looking. So there's our ghostie. It is now hunting. I need to hurry the F up or else I'm going to die. The plasma should save me. Okay, so when that happens, it just means that you were not within range of the ghost grabbing you. So we have the mirror, which you can use to summon the ghost as well. It also shows you where the ghost is looking. So use this at your own discretion. Hello? Particle counter not working? Oh! Okay, it's hunting. Leave me alone. Leave me alone, leave me alone, leave me alone. Okay, that was very close. I should grab a crucifix to help me if I actually want to get more evidence. All right, let's grab a cruci. So when you see these three little ropes on the crucifix, means it's got three uses. On insane mode, they only have one use. I'm also going to pick up a Ouija board. The way the Ouija board works is we need it to interact with the Ouija board, and this will tell us more or less more that we need to know about the ghost's age and such. So the Ouija board is either it doesn't interact with it, the little planchette moves from side to side, or it moves randomly. So I'm just going to throw it down over here and hope that it interacts with the Ouija board, and we'll go grab the voodoo doll. It's the same thing. No. No, 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 no. Don't do that. So there you see the plasma absorber working, protecting us from the ghost, which was close by. So we'll see if it does something with these objects. Did we get something? There we go. So once it's done reading, it tells us our count, which you can't see. The noise you're hearing is the growl. Sounds like it's snoring. So under radio, we want to say growl. So either it's aggressive or it's haunting. Particle counter, I'm just gonna get rid of my camera. It's 500 to 1000. So under particle counter would be 500 to 1000. Nice. Okay, so the fact that it's doing this means that the ghost has interacted, and it means that our Ouija board is moving randomly. Therefore, our ghost's age is ancient. So all we need to do is to figure out the mood and wait for it to either interact with the doll or not at all. So doesn't interact is an option as well. So that's all we have to wait for. And then we can start weakening the ghost. So I like to move the doll around. just in case it doesn't want to interact with it over there. Also, buying more equipment also helps. If you want to, of course. Oh, freaking hell. No. There she is. It's hunting me. I should be fine over here. We'll keep our Chrissy out just in case. The plasma saved me. Okay. I never, ever, 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 ever can be prepared for that. You can understand now what's going on. Awesome. I'm glad. I'm so, so glad. It just makes much more sense once you've actually played and understand. And this is exactly why I wanted to do this with you guys as well. So we're just waiting for it to either do something with the doll or not. So that does happen when the ghost hunts and it grabs you. It screams in your face, which is pretty jarring. Alright, so while we're waiting for the voodoo doll to actually do something, we're going to complete some of the side objectives. Alright, so we need to capture the ghost on a video. What I like to do is buy myself a video camera with the motion sensor. So what this does is if the ghost is detected by the camera, it's automatic and it does everything for you. So you wouldn't have to walk around, see it moving. You wouldn't have to walk around with the video camera, which is pretty damn sweet. Pretty sweet. This game needs to come with a warning. It's very, very, very jarring when that happens. Take a picture of the ghost's footprints. So we have a normal camera over here and we had the blood stains. I think that'll count. Nope. So that jingle is the sound of the side objective being marked off. Bro. She wanted me in the bathroom. Okay, this is our little cursed object. From time to time, you'll find that there's a cursed object. Well, always there'll be a cursed object in the house. Sometimes taking it back to the van also gives you extra money as an objective. But I'll take it back. We'll take Biggie with us. Alright, so we got the footprints and we got capture the video. You heard that. So now we need to irritate the ghost. Let's see if it's done anything with the voodoo doll. Otherwise, I'll get another one and then throw that down. It's a piggy. It's a snoring ghosty. Shh, guys. Ghost is sleeping. Ghost is sleeping. Alright, I'm gonna pick this up. I'm gonna move this over here. She closed the door. And hopefully she will do something. Otherwise, we can always just say doesn't interact, which makes it aggressive. Which I feel this ghost is quite aggressive. I'm not doing the EMF sensor since we already know that this is a vampire based on the bloodstains as well as the temperature. But if you want to, you can always do the EMF sensor just to make sure and see how it actually is. All right, so I am going to try and irritate the ghost. And then after that, we'll start weakening it with the steps provided. Yeah, ghosty. All right, so I'm going to aggro the ghost to show you guys. So if you look through the mirror, you can actually see. This is what the ghost is seeing, what it's looking at. It's in the kitchen. It's right in front of me over here. You can see me. There she goes. For some reason, that didn't irritate the ghost, which is weird. I think that might be a bug. I've not been able to irritate the ghost for a while. All right, so I'm going to see what I need in order to weaken the ghost. You're gonna cry, please don't cry. So we need to light 3 candles on the location and then get the withering light. So we've got withering light on already. I'm gonna grab a candle and we're gonna light up. Whoopsie. We're going to light up 3 candles. So here's one. No, ma'am. Please leave me alone. Here's another. And the third one. So for another candle. She is very, very, very aggressive now. Very active. It's so jarring. It is. It really is. So when that happens, it means that you've wakened the ghost. Your step is completed and she's walked into the withering light herself. So thank you, ghostie. So next we need to do a golden bomb. So our golden bomb would be basically this little stun grenade. This is the golden bomb. So I need her to attack me and then throw the golden bomb at her. Or if I see her, I can throw the golden bomb at her if my timing is right. But I'll play it out and just stand over here and be vulnerable for the ghostie and wait for her to attack me. Golden butt. It's golden bomb. Bomb. Oh my goodness. Butt spot. Could you not? All right. We could. Oh, she's hunting. I'm not sure where she is though. Hopefully she's close to me. No. That's a shame. Let's grab the mirror. Okay, she's in the kitchen. She's at the front of the house now. She's looking out the front door. Okay, she sees me. She's coming to me. So we want to left click when she grabs us. Done. All right. So that's done. I'm going to throw this down because we don't want to keep triggering her. Next, we want to blow out all the candles, which is quite straightforward. So just E to interact in the candle and that blows it out. Where was the third one? No, ma'ams. Leave me alone. Done. And next we want to get her on the plasma absorber and then get the holy salt. So I'm going to get the holy salt in the meantime. We're going to throw down this crucio over here. Don't need it for now. Speedy. Hi, Cuckoo. Welcome on in. How you doing? Thanks for the follow. What do we need? Holy salt, right? I think that is the holy salt, if I'm not mistaken. Let's just double check. Yeah. So, oh, the holy salt is the blue one. It's the shiny one. It's this one over here. So we want to get her with the plasma absorber, which is this over here. So I'm going to pick up the mirror to irritate her. She's upstairs in the pink bedroom. Hopefully she will come down. Ghostie. Hey, ghostie. There we go. Got him. So next we need her to attack me. I'll get her with the salt and then we can get the ball to capture her. So I'm gonna stand as far away as from that equipment as possible in order to make sure that it's successful. We don't need that just yet. You missed it. I'm sorry I missed your hair up, Miss Ghostie. She's not happy at all. All right, let's grab the mirror. I could follow her and throw the salt, but it's also risky because I might miss. If you see your screen shaking like this, it means you're also close to the ghost. But at the same time, I actually don't know where she is. Okay, she's hunting me. Can you come get me? Ghostie, come get me. There we go. Holy salt. So all I need to do now is capture her with the ball. So many steps. Yeah. Depending on the ghost, it can be quite a bit. So this is your capture ball thing, which I'm not 100% sure what the term is. It's called a ghost scasher. So all we want to do is just throw this at her. And then it's done. So now I got to look for her. There she is, Miss Mams. Done. Hey. And that's it. We've successfully captured the ghost. It's actually very easy. I don't find it to be too difficult. The steps and things may be a little bit confusing, but if as long as you're doing your evidence and things that you need to do according to your tablet, you'll be good. If you do plan on playing this on insane difficulty, do notice that some things will be altered and the door locks as soon as the ghost starts to hunt as well. So just be very careful. Make sure that you bring a friend or two. But if you have any questions, let me know. I'll be more than happy to help. I really enjoyed this game. I think it's got a lot of potential and it's absolutely so much fun. Let me know what you think. And yeah, thank you for watching.